Welcome back to the Arizona Daily Mix. My favorite place, I'm gonna get in trouble, my favorite place is the Arizona Science Center. I'm so excited that they are opening up to the public this Saturday, Siri.
Yep.
But you guys opened up last week to the members, and you guys have been really prepping for this ever since you had to shut down, because you know how important it is to get kids back into learning what the Arizona Science Center does, and it's really cool. So let's first talk about how you guys have been prepping and getting things ready for families to come back in.
Yeah, so I mean, as a science learning institution, we know it's absolutely critical for us to not only be educating about science and the disease, but also be modeling what it means to live, interact in, and adapt to a world with COVID-19. So we've taken all this into account. We've been speaking with experts, thinking about the cleanliness of the center and how we can operate and reimagine a whole new experience for guests so that we can experience science safely.
Yeah, let's first start that you guys are all wearing masks, and I like the masks, so I want
to- We are.
And we're social distancing right now, but I love that even when you've been out of the museum, you guys have been wearing your mask because you know it's very important because you guys are interacting with kids and stuff and you want everybody to be healthy going there. So
that's right.
I love that. And so.
Well, and we've been thinking about it all the time, but I mean, with this reopening, masks are absolutely required. My mask protects you, your mask protects me. So we've got our masks all the time. Our team is wearing them, guests will be wearing them. Social distancing is an absolute must at the Science Center. So we've got our lines set up to account for that. So any cues, there's a lot of space. We have over 200,000 square feet at the center. So we've got room to spread out, and thinking about this with our new guided experiences, there's only 10 people per group. So this gives you a chance to really spread out, thinking about the cleanliness, cleaning in between people who are using.
While the country was shut down.
It's, again, just a way to have fun while still doing it safely.
Yeah, and we know that you guys have also been doing online stuff with people. You've been teaching a lot, which is really cool, and some of the activities going on there. I want to show this because this is the new way that you're going to have people interacting with some of the activities there.
That's right. So we're going low touch and no touch wherever we can. So this touchless tool is a way to do that. On the ones we have at the Science Center, there's some conductive pieces, so you can use it on touch screens. You can use this tool to open doors, interact with exhibits, anywhere you can. And then, of course, when you can't, and we are a high-touch institution usually, so we're reducing the touches where we can, but really implementing hand hygiene breaks so that you're using hand sanitizer and also hand washing where we can.
Yeah, and also I got to mention that you guys kind of like designed these right there at the Arizona Science Center with your 3D printer.
We did. We 3D printed these, and then the ones we're using at the center are printed, cut on acrylic at our laser cutters in our Create Makerspace. So we're using our whole institution to create a whole new experience for you.
Okay, let's talk about some of the exhibits and some of the experience people get, which is kind of fun.
That's right. So it's a whole new reimagined Science Center, different than what you're used to experiencing. So our tours, our guided experiences, have four cool themes. So we've got everything from yuck, the science of gross. We've got the science of superpowers. We have stellar space science. And we have, of course, T-Rex Unearthed, the story of Victoria. Since we have Victoria the T-Rex at the Science Center.
I love this. This is so cool. And again, you want people to start going now because you want them to get their tickets because, again, you're limited to a certain amount of people.
Correct.
But if you're a member, you also kind of like, I'm not gonna say specially privileges, but you get a little opportunity to get into some of the exhibits a little ahead, so you know you wanna make sure the members are taken care of.
Yeah, so on these tours, it's not the free exploration that people remember, it's this really great themed out opportunity. I had a member mention to me this week, they're like, it's the best of the Science Center, and it's almost like your own private tour. So having a chance to interact with exhibits that are in that theme, whatever guided experience you're on, so it might be earth science, learning about paleontology, and then going into Victoria, or with the gross science, learning about anatomy, having your own dissections, some really great opportunities to engage, but just all different ways, again, to have science safely and to do it in this small group experience.
Yeah, I'll tell you, like I said, it's my favorite place to go to. I always love going down there and a good time, especially when they kind of blow things up. It's really cool. Okay, the website?
The website is azscience.org. So if you're looking to book your guided experience, we encourage online ticketing before you come to the Science Center. You're going to go there for all the ticket times. Some times have changed again, and also our hours have changed with the availability of those guided experiences. So you're going to want to go there first, and you'd already mentioned this, but we're open for members this week and then the public starting June 20th.
Like it. And I want to mention really quick too, you guys usually do summer camps, but you aren't right now, so you're asking them to go online and check out some of the stuff you have offer there for the kids.
So we actually do have some limited on-site camps, some very small groups again, groups of 10, but we are offering virtual camps for anybody who wants to take advantage of those too, and all that information is also at azscience.org.
Thank you, Siri.
Anytime.